Hello friends, I am Professor Vyam Khan and today we'll cover one of the big M method problem with objective function to maximize the Z. So this is a maximization problem. In last video we have seen the problem of minimization and how to perform the big M method, and today we'll cover the problem of maximization. Okay, now the given problem to us is maximize z is equal to 3x1 minus x2, which is subject to 2x1 plus x2 less than or equal to 2. Here the constraint is, the inequality sign is less than or equal to. Okay, so we do not need to add artificial variable to this particular constraint, will only add slack variable to it. And the next constraint is x1 plus 3 x2 greater than or equal to 3. So the constraint here is greater than or equal to, so we have to subtract slack variable from it, and we have to add artificial variable to this particular constraint. Now the next constraint is x2 less than or equal to 4. So again, less than or equal to sign is there, so therefore no need to add artificial variable, just add slack variable, that is S3. Now step one is our regular method, that is setting the problem into standard form. So we will add, we'll introduce slack variables, surplus variables and artificial variables. Like here we have to add surplus, here we have to add slack variable, here we have to subtract surplus variable, as well as we have to add artificial variable. Then here we have to add slack variable. So three slack variables and one artificial variable will be added, or you can say subtracted from these constraints. Okay, will be introduced into these constraints, as well as they will be introduced into our objective function. Now here the objective function is to maximize z, and for maximizing z, or for a maximization problem, the coefficient of this artificial variable is taken minus. Okay, in a minimization problem we have taken it as a plus m, now here we have to take it as a minus m. So the objective function becomes 3x1 minus x2 plus 0s1 plus 0s2 plus 0s3 and minus ma1. This is a large penalty and it is negative. Okay, since this problem is of maximization, if it was of minimization we would have been taken this m as a positive, which is subject to 2x1 plus x2 plus S1, since the sign is less than or equal to, so the slack variable is enough for it. Okay, now next one is greater than or equal to, so we have to subtract surplus variable from it, that is your S2, and we have to add artificial variable to it, that is A1, and that is equal to 3. And the next one is X2, so we have to only add slack variable here, that is S3. So in this way we have converted this the problem into the standard form. Now we can put the values of x1, x2 is equal to 0 to get the value of s1. Since there is no artificial variable, so we'll use slack variable here. Then we have to put x1, x2 and s2 equal to 0 to get the value of a1. Since artificial variable here is available, so this will be put into basis column in simplex table, and here we'll put x2 is equal to 0 to get the value of s3. So we have to find the value of s1, a1 and s3, and we have to put these three variables into the column of basis. Okay, now we'll continue to that, and before that we'll there is one more thing to be discussed, that is x1, x2, s1, s2, s3, a1 is greater than or equal to 0. So that is your feasible alternatives. Now finding initial basic feasible solution we'll put x1, x2, h2 is equal to 0 in the constraints, and we'll get s1 is equal to 2, a1 is equal to 3, and s3 is equal to 4, whereas the function z will be equals to minus 3m. Okay, now this m is a large penalty, so this is going to be removed, okay, from the solution, and we'll iterate until the values of cj minus zj are either negative or zero, because this is a maximization problem. Okay, so the table is as follows. You write the first column, you write the first row, that is the coefficients of your objective function. So your objective function is 3x1 minus x2 0 plus 0s1 plus 0s2 plus 0s3 minus ma1. So you write the objective function's coefficient here. Okay, then you write the basis variable here, your s1, a1 and s3. Okay, now their respective coefficients from your objective function will be written here. Okay, similarly, the first constraint will be written here, the second will be written here, the third will be written here, and the values of zj and cj minus zj will be computed. So first of all, we'll write the first row, first constraint. So it is your 2x1 plus x2 plus s1 equal to 2. So this is the first constraint. The second constraint, a1 is having minus m value in your objective function, minus 1 coefficient in the objective function. So you write minus m under the column of cb. Okay, then we write the constraints of the coefficients of second constraints, then we write the coefficients of third constraint. Okay, we'll compute zj. Now zj is nothing but cb multiplied by aj, aij. So 0 multiplied by 2 plus minus m multiplied by 1 plus 0 multiplied by 0. So it will come around minus 1. This will be minus 3m. This will be 0m, 0 minus m, 3m, minus 3m. So we compute zj as well as we compute cj minus zj. Cj is 3, and out of cj we have to subtract zj, so 3 minus minus plus m, so this becomes 3 plus m. Okay, now here it is minus 1, so minus 1 minus minus plus 3m, so minus 1 plus 3m. So in this way we have computed the values of cj minus zj. Now we'll perform optimality test, or we'll check whether the solution is optimal or not. For a case of maximization, the cj minus zj in every column has to be 0 or negative. It has to be 0, at least 0 or negative. But if we see here, this is 3 plus m and this is minus 1 plus 3m. So if you put a value to this m like 10, we'll get some value in this both columns. Okay, and that could be a positive value, so it means that the x1 and x2 column are positive here. So that means that the current feasible solution is not optimal. Okay, now we have to check which one of these two value is you can say greater, because we have to select the most positive cj minus zj for entering into the column, or for selecting the key column. So if you put the value, some value here, so like if you put 10 here, so you'll get 3 plus m is equal to 13, and if you put 10 here, so you'll get 30 minus 1, that is 29. So this one is more positive, so therefore we'll enter into this column, and your x2 will be your incoming variable. And now you have to find out of these three variables one as a leaving variable, and that will be selected from this particular theta. Now this theta is computed by dividing the key, dividing the column of B by the key column. So 2 divided by 1, here will be 1. 3 divided by 3, here will get 1. 4 divided by 1 will get 4. So this is your theta, and out of this theta we have to select the least positive, okay, least positive, minimum positive value. So that is your 1. So you will select this key row, this will be your key row, this is your key column, and the intersection will give us the key element. So 3 is our key element. Now A1 is your leaving variable, so A1 will be deleted in next column and X2 will be replaced by A1. Okay, now the X2, your entering variable, A1, leaving variable, 3 is your key element. Now in next table, we have to make this 3 a unity. So we'll divide the whole row by 3. So this will become 1 by 3, this will become 1, this will be 0, this will become minus 1 by 3, 0, 1 by 3, 1. Okay, similarly, we have to make these two digits, that is the value of key column, remaining values in key column, 0. We have to make them 0. So as to make this one 0, it is to be subtracted from 1. So we'll perform the row operation as per our regular method. So 1 minus 1 will give here 0. So S1 changes to this has to be made 1, so it is to be divided by 3. So you can say S1 changes to S1 minus 1 by 3 A1. Okay, S1 minus 1 by 3 A1. So it will give us this value 0. Similarly, S3 changes to S3 minus 1 by 3 A1. Okay, so these two values will get 0, and the remaining values are to be computed similarly, like this will be 2 minus 1 by 3, so it will become 5 by 3, this will be your 1 minus 1 by 3, so on. So everything is to be computed similarly. No, this one be 1 as it is, because here 0 is there, so you have to compute the remaining values. So A1 is leaving variable, so A1 is replaced by X2. Now performing row operation by usual way, solution will become optimal when all Cj minus Zj becomes 0 or negative. Since A1 is leaving, so we delete the column of A1 from the table. So we have deleted the column of A1. We have written the new row of X2. So the coefficient of X2 is written here in this column of Cb. X2's coefficient is minus 1. It is to be written from objective function. Objective function, you have to use it. Now this is your entering variable. Since A1 is leaving variable, we have deleted the column, and we'll compute the remaining values of row S1 and S3. Okay, so it comes around like this. Now after computing that, we'll find Zj and Cj minus Zj. So after finding Cj minus Zj, we come to know that the four values are negative, four values are either negative or 0, 3 of which are 0 and 1 is negative, but there is one positive value here. There is only one positive value here, so no need to search for another positive value. We'll enter into this column. So this is the key column now, because since there is one positive value, the current feasible solution is not optimal, so we have to iterate again. So we'll first select the key column, then we'll compute the theta, then out of this theta we'll select the key row with least positive theta. So this one is your least positive theta. So S1 will be your leaving variable and X1 will be your entering variable. So we'll put X1 here. In next column, the value or the coefficient of X1 will be written here, and the remaining things will be computed as per the regular procedure. Okay, the next step is here. So we have computed the whole table here. This one is made unity, this 5 by 3, 3 is multiplied by 3 by 5 to make it unity. The remaining elements are made 0. The value of CB is written here, that is the coefficient of x1 from objective function. Then the beta is b column is computed and CJ minus ZJ is computed as well. So if you see the value of CJ minus ZJ, the values here are either 0 or negative. That means the current feasible solution is our optimal solution because there is no positive value in this particular row. So the solution is over, and since all CJ minus ZJ are 0 or negative, here it should be negative. So please correct it. All CJ minus ZJ are negative because this is a maximization problem. The current feasible solution is optimal. So we'll find the value of Z max, and to find it, we have x1 and x2. These two are the basic variables. Now their respective value of V will be put into objective function. X1 is equals to 3 by 5, x2 is equals to 4 by 5, and these values are to be put into this equation. So we'll get value Z max is equals to 1. So your Z max is also available here. So Z max is your final value. Okay, so thanks for watching it. Stay home, stay safe, keep learning, and stay healthy. Thank you.